CAD modeling software. So we are going to use Creo Parametric 4.0 software. So let us open Creo Parametric 4.0. So this is home screen of Creo Parametric 4.0. Here we can see two options, that is new and open. This, if you want to draw a new part, then we can click on new. If we want to open already drawn part, we can click on open. So here we are going to see new sketches. So see, these are the things which we can perform in Creo Parametric software, starting from layout, 2D sketches, 3D parts, 3D assembly, manufacturing, drawing, format and notebooks. Also there are subtypes based on type of your part, whether it is solid, sheet metal or bulk. Okay, so here we are going to draw a sketch, 2D sketch. So we will select a type sketch. Here name of that sketch, PRT1. Let us consider part 1. Okay. Okay, we will give another name. So this is the sketching command which is on. You can see here, these are different sketching options like setup, get data, datum features are there. Then sketching command is there, editing is there, constraints. These constraints we are going to study now, dimensions and inspection. Okay, so this is the working area where we are going to draw sketches. Here we can call it as a model tree, where all things whatever we perform in the software will be available here in model tree. Here is a command box. So whenever we select any command, the next step what to do will be written over here. So first we will see what is constraint. So constraint is nothing but a limitation or a restriction we are putting on the geometry or a sketch. So there are basically two types of constraints. One is geometrical constraint and second is dimensional constraint. So geometrical constraint includes, which is shown here, we can see here, vertical. If any line is a vertical, it is a type of constraint. Horizontal, perpendicular, tangent, midpoint, coincident, symmetric, equal and parallel. So all these 9 are under comes under title geometric constraints. And second is a dimensional constraint. So whatever dimension we provide to the sketch, that is also one type of constraints. Now we will see one by one all geometrical constraints and dimensional constraints. For that, let us select a line command, and in working area I'll click on start point of line. You can observe here now only line is appearing in front of our screen. Now you can see one symbol is there with this line. So what is that symbol indicates? It indicates that this line is a horizontal line. So whatever the second constraint shown here, that is horizontal. If line becomes horizontal, then there will be a constraint of horizontal line. So that symbol is appearing on that line. Same as that of, let us draw one vertical line. So starting point, if it is not a vertical, then symbol will not be there or constraint will not be there. But if it is vertical, then vertical symbol will be there, or that is a constraint. So you can observe here, and also one dimension is appearing over here. So that dimension, if we edit this dimension, suppose I will give 10 units of length. So you can see here what is difference. See, this is weak dimension which I have not edited, right? This color of dimension is blue, and the dimension which I have edited, its color is a purple. Okay, so why this difference is there, you can observe here. I have edited this dimension. Before editing, its color was a blue. And if we move cursor on this dimension, it is showing that it is a weak dimension. So until and unless you edit that dimension, it will be a weak dimension. Once you edit that dimension, so this is 20 units, then it will be a strong dimension. See, these two dimensions are strong now. This care we have to take, that we have to make each and every dimension strong. Okay, so this 10 is dimensional constraint for this line, and horizontal is a geometrical constraint for this line, and for this line 20 is a dimensional constraint and vertical is a geometrical constraint. Now let us see how this perpendicular constraint is working. So I will draw one more line here which is not a horizontal. Now we want these two lines to be a perpendicular to each other. So for that, let us click on perpendicular and you can read this command: select two entities to make them orthogonal or a perpendicular. So after clicking on this, the command box is showing that you have to perform this operation. So what is that operation? Select two entities to make them orthogonal or a perpendicular. So we have to select two lines which we want to make a perpendicular or a orthogonal. So first line, click on second line, they will become a perpendicular. Now that constraint is appearing here, you can observe here, constraint orthogonal entities strong, which is a strong constraint because they are actually perpendicular to each other. And if we move the cursor on any symbol of perpendicular, both the symbols constraints will be highlighted. It shows that these two lines are perpendicular to each other. Okay, now let us see tangent constraint. For that we have to draw one circle. So I'll draw one circle over here. Let us make dimension strong. Suppose 10 unit circle is there. Now we want this circle or this line to be tangent to this circle. Right now they are not tangent to each other, but when we click on tangent command, let us see what command box says. It says that select two entities to make them tangent. So what are these two entities? First is line, second is a circle. Now see which symbol appearing here. Constraint tangent entities strong, as they are tangent to each other. So this constraint is a strong constraint. Okay, now let us see next constraint, that is midpoint constraint. So for that, let us click or select line command. We want to draw one vertical line from midpoint of this line. So where is the midpoint? Let us travel on this line. Yes, some different symbol is appearing over here. See here, it is a coincident symbol, but at this point the symbol is different, and that symbol is nothing but symbol of midpoint. See, perpendicular, this line is perpendicular to this green line or highlighted line, and also it is from midpoint. So see how many constraints are appearing over here. So first is perpendicular. See, both lines are perpendicular to each other, and second is a this midpoint symbol. Midpoint symbol is appearing over here. So that's why these dimensions are not appeared. As it is from midpoint, so no need to give dimensions to both sides. Okay. Now see, next is a coincident. For that, let us click on line command. Draw one line. Now let us see how this coincident constraint works. So if you want to coincide this point with this point, let us click on coincident constraint. I want, see, command box is showing select two entities or vertices to align. So this is my first vertex and this is second. So both are coincident to each other. Also, if we want this line and this end point to coincide, that can be also possible. So let us click on coincident constraint, this line and this point. You can observe here coincident symbol is appearing over here. Coincident point on entity. So on this line, this point of this line is line. So this is what coincident constraint. Now next is a symmetric constraint. So for that we have to draw one center line. So I'll draw center line. Okay, and two lines which I want to symmetric about this center line. So suppose this is first line, this is second line. They are arbitrarily drawn. Now we want, see this, there is a difference. From center line, this line is 16.73, this line is 24.87. Instead of editing both the dimensions, we can give constraint of symmetry. So let us click on symmetry. So in command box it is showing that select a center line and two vertices to make them symmetric. So first select the center line. And suppose these two vertices we will select. So now these two lines are symmetric about this center line. Okay. Now let us check whether they are symmetric. We'll edit this dimension. But suppose now it is 20.80, we will give 40. So both the line will be at distance 40 from center line. Suppose this is 10, both will be at 10. So this is what advantage of constraint. And this is the symbol of symmetry. See, both symbols are highlighting at a time. If we move cursor on any symbol, okay. So next is a equal constraint, means length or any dimension that may be equal. Suppose now this line is of 25.17 length and this is 34.67. Now if we want both the lines of same dimension, then we can use this constraint. So let us click on equal constraint, select two or more lines. Okay, so first line and second line. Now both the lines are of dimension 29.92. Let us cross check. Let us edit this dimension. Suppose this is 50. So both lengths will be 50. Suppose this is 15. Both lengths will be 50. Okay. This constraint is applied on these lines. And this is symbol of equal constraints. Both lines are equal. Suppose I will draw one more line somewhere here, and if I want dimension of this line and this line and this new line same, then I will go without clicking second point. See, this line is highlighting with green color, and one symbol is coming with this line, that is equal symbol, means the green color line and this drawn line are of equal length. Again there will be one more equal constraint. Let us take example of this circle also. Now circle is of 10 units. If I want to draw another circle, see both, means first circle is highlighting with green color, and on the second circle or which I am drawing, there is equal constraint. So I can click on this point and there will be equal constraint automatically. Now next is a parallel constraint. So two entities are parallel to each other. So let us draw one two lines arbitrarily, first and this is second. Now they are not parallel to each other, but we want these two lines to be parallel to each other. Then click on this constraint parallel, select two or more lines to make them parallel. You can select two or more than two lines. So first and second, both are parallel to each other. So these are different types of geometrical constraints, and also we have seen dimensional constraints. By using these constraints, we will draw one simple 2D sketch. So I will show you that sketch. So we want to draw this sketch. So let us start with new file sketch. Okay, so So this is very important step to read the given drawing. That is very important. You have to check whether there is a symmetry present or not. Then dimensions are properly given or not. This is a very important step to read given geometry properly. And there should be a plan in your mind how you are going to draw this sketch, from where you are going to start and from where you are going to end. So in less time we have to complete the drawing. That should be the motto of any designer. So if we observe carefully this drawing, dimensions, all dimensions are clear. So total length is 12. Two circles are there, so say centers of these circles are, one is 3.6 from this end, second is 8.4. so I think this point is good to start because all dimensions are given from this point. So let us start from this point. By selecting line command, we will draw all these shapes and then at the end two circles. So by using circle command we can draw it. So from this point, if we start in clockwise direction, so first line will be of 4.4 mm. Let us start. Select the line command, starting point. So I don't know the dimension, but I know this line is a vertical line, so there should be a vertical constraint. This is first step. So let us continue and we will give dimension at end. So it is like this. Now we can give dimensions. So first line is of 4.4 unit. So give 4.4. Now this dimension becomes a strong. You can see here. And also for this line, vertical constraint is there, which is strong. Now second line, so 3.2 by 3.2 dimensions are there. So this dimension is 3.2 and also this dimension is 3.2, but it is not shown here, so we can give dimension. Two entities we have to select. So we will select this line and this point. This is also 3.2. So next line is of 4.4 unit. 4.4. Next, this dimension is not given, but total length is given, that is 12. We can give direct total length 12. Only one dimension is weak, that is this one. So we'll see what is that dimension length. Now to give this dimension, let us observe here. These two dimensions are equal. This 4.4, this is also 4.4 because they are in one line. So we'll give 4.4. So this is complete or extra without circle. This is complete. All dimensions are strong. Also constraints are there, vertical, horizontal. Now we have to draw circle. So let us draw one circle, first one, whose diameter is 3.6 units. So we don't know exactly where it is. Dimensions are there with us, we can give dimensions. Diameter is 3.6 and from this end it is 3.6 and 3.6 unit apart. So 3.6. This is over. Now second circle, which is 2.1 unit diameter. And from this side, so its dimension is given from this end. So it is 8.4 and from bottom it is 2. From bottom it is 2. but here dimension is given from this end, so we can calculate that dimension. So it is 12 minus 8.4. So directly you can put here 12 minus 8.4. So this is complete 2D sketch with geometrical constraints and dimensional constraints. See, only vertical, horizontal, vertical and horizontal, this much constraints are applied, because other constraints are not present here, like no tangency is there, no perpendicular lines are there, no equal lines are there and no symmetric lines are there. So this is how we draw 2D sketches by using geometrical and dimensional constraints. Hope it is clear. So thank you.